that once was crowned with thorns is crowned with glory now.
So I'm on my way to the hospital this afternoon to spend some time with my dad. He's up there in ICU. And I've also been doing a lot of thinking about our small group meetings and just considering, really, based on what I've been reading in our book, is really there's a lot of similarities between the temple and the hospital. And going to the hospital, I've spent quite a few days there now. I realize the hospital has a lot of different sections. They have the ICU department. They have maternity. They have general medicine. They have a ward for people with emotional and mental issues, and they have an emergency room for urgent care. Lots of different things. They have labs, they have x-ray units, and each one of those has specialized doctors and specialized nurses, all different kinds of nurses that wear all different kinds of colored clothes so that you can identify them. And then there's support staff that support all of them. It's pretty interesting. The same sort of structure existed in the temple and the tabernacle that was ordained by God so that it could work in a certain way. And the purpose and the goal of the tabernacle was that people would be enabled to worship God. And so there's different pieces of furniture, all of them very deliberate, and all of them either facilitating worship or teaching us something very important about worship. Is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King. Your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King. Yeah.
By Spirit.
So here I am at HEB Methodist Hospital in Euless, and I'm about ready to go in and see my dad, and I'm thinking about some of the similarities again before I even get inside there, and I'm reminded of what Jesus said in John chapter 10 verse 9. He said, "I am the gate," and it reminds me that there is no way for us to get in past the altar and into the outer court, into the inner court, into the deeper places within the temple. There's no way for us to approach those places without first going in through the gate. And Jesus makes the declaration that He is the gate. In worship of God, there's no fence jumping. In getting into heaven, there's no fence jumping. It all starts and ends with Jesus Himself. And Psalm 100 verse 4 tells us how we're to get in through the great gate, in what manner we're to go in. And it says, "Enter His gates with thanksgiving and enter His courts with praise." Before we really approach God, we have to approach Him with a thankful heart and a praising heart that worships and adores this King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And we learn very quickly in Scripture that Jesus is the password that opens that door. There's only one way in, and that's through His gate. Hi, I've taken over the waiting room here at the ICU ward in the hospital and been studying our book a little, and we were talking about altars this week, and I got to thinking about the different altars that the Lord has put in my life. Now in our church we have an altar. It's unlike the one that we'll read about in the book, but the purpose of it is still very similar. At each of these altars, something in me needed to die so that I could be healed, so that I could have a closer relationship with God. And I was kind of running through them in my mind, and I remember
the altar at youth camp when I was a kid. And it was at that altar where I confessed my sins and I started my relationship with God. To me, that altar was my altar of salvation. And, you know, I still come to this altar frequently and ask the Lord to search my heart and to reveal any unclean ways. And so, in a very real way, we come back to that altar, and we should regularly, to keep a humble and submissive attitude before the Lord. It really improves our worship. But then when I was in Bible college, I remember a particular evening. I don't remember the sermon, but I just knew that the Lord touched my heart and said, what I really want of you, Colin, is to surrender your life, your plans, your future, your will for whatever you thought you would be doing, and just give that to me. And so I did. I went down. I remember it was an insane, amazing experience with the Lord there at the altar in Bible college. And I also remember it was just a few years later, and I was in the beginnings of becoming a pastor and had gone through all the studies and associated work that's alongside of that. And on a particular night, the night of my ordination, I was brought down to an altar of prayer. And at that altar, five of the most godly men that I knew on the face of the planet stood over me, and they laid their hands on me. And I'd really hoped that my grandfather could be there, but he had just recently passed away. But I had his Bible, and these men prayed over me at this altar of ordination, where I had surrendered my future to the Lord to do what it was that He had equipped me and called me and gifted me to do. That's what happened at the altar of ordination. Then after that, I met my wife, and part of entering into a relationship with the person that's going to be your wife is you go to an altar of matrimony, the wedding altar. And I did, and there's something interesting about that altar too, because it's ordained of God, marriage is of God, and you cannot be in a marriage and be selfish. You are committing yourself in that moment, and I remember I did this. I committed myself to loving my wife as Christ loved the church. And that's a huge commitment. All of these are huge commitments, and they're all done at a place of sacrifice, where we lay down a little bit of ourselves so that we can have more of God. Isn't that what worship's about? I wonder, in your small groups tonight, what altars has the Lord led you to? Significant moments or waypoints in your life where you surrendered something to Him. Maybe you've been to some of the same altars I have, and maybe the Lord's led you to some different experiences where you surrendered something to Him. And maybe go around the room right now and share your altar experiences with the people here, and how, when you responded, how did it impact your relationship with God? God bless you guys. I'll see you next week.